The multiple choice question is a super simple closed-end question that lets your respondents choose only one answer from a list of choices. Whether you're asking people if they disagree or agree with a statement, or how satisfied they are with an experience or product, the multiple choice question is one of the most useful question types around. I'd like to take you through how to set up this question and how your data will look when you view your results. Let's check it out. Just a quick tip, the multiple choice question only lets people choose one answer, so if you want people to be able to select all the choices that apply to them, use the checkboxes question instead. Now down to business. Once you've added the multiple choice question to your survey, just enter your question at the top and then add any answer choices below. There are a few ways to add answer choices. When you click on the last answer choice, a new one is automatically added below, but you can click the plus button to add more as well. If you're using a more common question format, there's a good chance you'll find the answer choices you need in Answer Genius. Just pick the type of answer you want, and we'll fill in the rest for you, so you don't have to worry as much about wording things the right way to get good data. And if you've already written your question somewhere else, click Bulk Answers and copy and paste your list of answer choices, so you don't have to type them in one by one. If you need to delete one, just click the minus button and poof, it's gone. If your survey is a test or quiz, the Score This Question setting will make this a quiz question, which lets you add points to correct answers and give people a quiz score at the end of your survey. If your list of answers doesn't cover all possible options, add a none of the above choice, or an other text box as an answer choice. This way, people can enter their own answers instead of choosing one of yours. This can be especially important for required questions. Otherwise, people might get stuck and feel unable to answer the question if none of the choices apply to them. There are even more settings under the Options tab, like the option to require people to answer the question. You can also set up a question text A/B test, which lets you test and compare different versions of question text to see how the results might differ. When you view your results, your multiple choice questions will show in an easy-to-read bar chart with a data table should you need a bit more detail. If you're looking for a different format, we've got you covered. Click Customize to change things to suit your style. If you're feeling hungry, you can use the donut or pie charts, but the multiple choice question supports all other charts, including different versions of the bar chart. Click Display Options to change more options. For instance, it could be nice to see the exact percentage of responses for each answer choice. Click Data in Chart, and that'll appear in your chart. You can even change the amount of decimal places you see, depending on how exact you need your numbers. The labels let you edit any label in the question, including the question text itself. Perfect for longer labels that can be shortened for charts. When you have your data looking the way you want, you can export with the rest of your data, or export it on its own whenever you'd like.